Hi guys, it's me, Indy, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to make a paper version of our robot puppy from our new app, Codes and Clues. For this project, you'll need two different colors of construction paper, the printout version of the robot puppy's head and tail that you can get off of our website, tape, a glue stick, and scissors. Now, you can make this robot puppy with whatever color of construction paper you want. Here we have a version that is blue and purple that I made earlier today. But today, for this video, we're going to be making their traditional colors of light and dark purple. It's the same colors that the robot puppy in our new app, Codes and Clues, is. First, what you'll need to do is to take the construction paper and fold it lengthwise. Once you fold it lengthwise, you'll need to cut down the middle. Once you cut it down the middle, tape it together to make one long strip of construction paper. I like to tape it completely on both sides just to make sure that it won't fall apart. So you'll end up with this one long piece of construction paper of your first color. So next you're going to take your second piece of construction paper, this one is dark purple in our case, fold it in half just like you did with your other piece of construction paper and repeat the entire process. So now that you have two long strips of construction paper in different colors, you're going to need to clear an area around you and then make an L with the construction paper, like this. I have my light purple piece over my dark purple piece to create an L. Now what I'll do to secure it so it sticks is to take my glue stick and glue the light purple piece on top of my dark purple piece. Make sure that you press it down so that you know it's safely secured. Once you did that, you'll start making the same pattern over and over. First, you'll flip this dark purple piece over to create another L shape. You'll do the same thing with the light purple piece. That's how you'll create this spring. Put the dark purple over the light purple. Now, if you just use two pieces of construction paper, it won't be very long. So what I like to do to make my robot puppy longer is take another long piece of paper and tape it together. That way your robot puppy will be twice as long. So again, you can put one piece of tape on, or I like to put tape all around on both sides so that it doesn't fall off. So now that we have a longer light purple section, now we'll take the extra dark purple piece and tape that on as well. This way, your robot puppy will be the same length as the one shown here. So we just continue the same pattern that we were doing earlier. Fold the dark purple piece over. Then we fold the light purple piece over. Fold the dark purple piece over. And fold the light purple piece over. You just keep doing this until you run out, and then you'll glue the ends together. Once you do that, you may have a little bit of excess construction paper on this corner. So what I do is I just trim it off with my scissors. That way it can have a nice even feel and stand up without tipping over. There you have your complete body for your robot puppy. So the next decision you make is you can either have the main part of its body this light purple or this dark purple. We already have one that has the main part of its body, the dark purple, so today I'm going to do the main part of its body, this light purple. So next what you'll do is you'll take your printout of your robot puppy face and tail and cut it out. You want to try and stay either on the black line or just outside of the black line, that way you don't cut off any of the face or the tail of the actual robot puppy. Once you have the head cut out, you'll put glue all on the back of the robot puppy's head. And then glue it on the body. What I like to do is kind of glue it somewhere in the middle. That way just a little bit of the head and the ears are coming off of the paper. Like that. So the next thing that we'll have to cut out is the tail. The tail is a lot trickier to cut out than the robot head. Just because of the spirals that you see, those are pretty hard to get in between. So what I like to do is actually take a hole punch and punch those parts out. Once you have the tail cut out, you'll glue that on the back. So put the glue stick on the front of the tail, that's right, the colored part of the tail. Then you set up your robot puppy and you will put it in the back. If you want, you can actually use some extra construction paper to make feet for your robot puppy. What I do is I take the opposite color of what its body is. So since my robot puppy, the main part of its body is light purple, I cut it from dark purple construction paper. So to do that, I fold my little piece in half, that way I have even feet. And then I cut out just kind of these half oval shapes. They kind of look like hills. And glue that onto the front body of my robot puppy to be his feet. If you want after that, since everything else on the robot puppy is kind of outlined in black, I like to take a fine tip black marker or even a black pen will work and outline the feet just so it matches the rest of the body. Once you've done that, you're ready to name and play with your robot puppy. I think I'll name mine Togo.